attend this program through online. My humble greetings and green wishes to all. I consider this opportunity of delivering a talk in commemoration of the late lamented Venerable Father Aprem Ramban, who served this institution in different levels as lecturer, as HOD of Botany Department, as principal, and as local manager for about 3 decades. He was the soul and spirit of the institution during that period. He was my guru, facilitator in one way or other way, and well-wisher in every dimension. It was his long-cherished desire to make the botany department as postgraduate one. During his lifetime, it was not materialized, and today, as I firmly believe that, his soul is getting rejoiced when the department has grown as fully fledged, well-equipped PG department. For this achievement, I take this opportunity to glorify Almighty God first and to thank the present management of Mount Tabor, our beloved MLA Sri Ganesh Kumar, Father Dr. David Koshi, Dr. Lala Dos, Father Dr. Mikhail Abraham, etc., for their efforts and endeavor in materializing this goal. My special thanks and concern for Mr. Ganesh Kumar MLA for all his philanthropic actions and attitudes. In the beginning of the talk itself, I bow my head in utmost reverence and humility before the sacred memory of Saint Stephen, our holy patron saint, late lamented Marthoma Dionysius, our founder manager, all the holy gurus and fathers, and specifically our very reverend Father Aprem Ramban, whom we are commemorating today. As Very Reverend Father Aprem Ramban was a professor in plant science, I prefer to speak the ecological roles of plants in nurturing all the life forms on our planet, the earth. It is a fundamental property of plants as far as the sustenance, abundance, and rhythmicity of life on our planet is concerned. As a prologue to this topic, I just brief the arena of plant science and ecology in a nutshell, which perhaps you know better than me. Plants and plant science. Plant science, as it traditionally called botany, also known as plant biology or phytology, which is supposed to be the mother science of all biological sciences. Plants include all the biological life forms, either single or multicellular, which could able to synthesize organic molecules as food by fixing solar energy into chemical energy in these molecules with the help of their own plastids, except fungi and certain parasitic plant forms. This phenomenon is popularly known as photosynthesis. In short, apart from other criteria, the main feature that characterizes plant is the potency of carrying out photosynthesis. It is aided by the chlorophyll, complex green pigment molecules in the thylakoid structure of chloroplasts. It was first identified and separated by French chemists Pelletier and Carpentier in 1818. And it is estimated to be present in every leaf, 0.05% to 0.20% of its total weight. The phenomenon of photosynthesis that includes both light reaction during the daytime and dark reaction during the nighttime actually involves 3 crucial activities. Transferring solar energy and fix them within the carbohydrate molecule first. Secondly, utilization of poisonous carbon dioxide molecules for carbohydrate synthesis, and thirdly, release of oxygen molecules as byproduct of water molecule dissociation into hydrogen and oxygen. It is assumed based on available paleontological information that certain prokaryotic organisms like bacteria, who could carry out photosynthesis, lived around 300 crores of years back. Among the assessed extant species of around 80 lakhs life forms, 5 lakhs, that include plants and algae, have the potency of carrying out photosynthesis. The estimation is that a total of almost 2 into 10,040 tons of carbohydrate per annum is being produced by way of photosynthesis phenomenon. Therefore, plants and their leaves are very well known as the kitchen of the earth. You should specifically note this. The plants and their leaves are generally known as the kitchen of the earth. The plants, the production of food and respiratory oxygen through photosynthesis by plants is the fundamental resource for the sustenance of life in various terrestrial, marine and other varied ecosystems on our planet, without which there is no life at all. This is the utmost commendable importance of plants and plant science as far as ecology is concerned, although there are many roles that plants contribute. Modern plant science is broad, multidisciplinary subject with contributions and insights from most other areas of science and technology. Research topics include the study of plant structure, growth and differentiation, reproduction, biochemistry and primary metabolism, chemical products, development, diseases, evolutionary relationship, systematics and plant taxonomy. Dominant themes in 21st century plant science are molecular genetics and epigenetics. I think you may be knowing, as botany students, you may be knowing everything. We study the mechanisms and control of gene expression during differentiation of plant cells and tissues. Botanical research has diverse applications in providing staple foods, materials such as timber, oil, rubber, fiber, and drugs, in modern horticulture, agriculture, and forestry. Plant propagation, breeding, and genetic modification in the synthesis of chemicals and raw materials for construction and energy production, in environmental management and the maintenance of biodiversity. The second aspect I consider is ecology and environmental science. It's a vast ocean. I am just briefing. Ecology and environment are very familiar terms nowadays, as both terms mean the same in common parlance that influence and affects the people at every dimension in their day-to-day life. Though both spells the same, their approaches are different. Ecology denotes more or less an academic discourse regarding living and non-living factors and their intra and interrelationships that confine almost within the biological arena. It is equivalent to environmental biology. Environment, on the contrary, denotes everything under the sun that directly or indirectly affects and influences life and life processes, and hence its borders are broader and wide. It encompasses all sorts of scientific information and technology under one umbrella, environmental science. Ecology or environmental science is basically a science of life relations, and it started merely as an academic discourse in the mid-decades of 20th century But in the context of environmental crisis and degradation of life quality today, it has become the most relevant subject and aspect of study in regarding the life survival and life causality on our planet. The scientific understanding of the environment was earlier as two-dimensional structural entity that include living and non-living factors and their togetherness. That understanding is now being totally changed to three-dimensional functional entity rather than structural entity. That include, apart from living and non-living factors, human factors also. The anthropocentric and anthropomediated human interaction on environment is crucial. Moreover, the environment and its healthy sustenance is based on optimum intra and interrelations rather than structural aspects. Earlier, we speak about eco-crisis and environmental degradation, but all these have culminated in a cumulative situation of eco-sustenance and environmental causality. And Karvinu vendi parayana nerthe nammal eco-crisis, eco-degradation okke paranju ippo adakku poi. Now it is eco-sustenance and environmental causality, because it is the very question of existence. In short, it is the question of very survival of life on our planet Earth rather than mere crisis and degradation. There are three groups of environmentalists as far as this question is concerned. The first group is known as environmental catastrophists, and for them the entire life supporting system of our planet will be collapsed within a tenure of 30 to 40 years if we continue our damaging activities on nature at the present pace. The second group is the environmental optimists, and according to them, no need to worry as nature has its own corrective and rectifying measures to correct the detrimental damages and degradation happening on the nature. Moreover, we have our own strategies, tools and technology with us to revive and the damaged ecosystems. The third group, who are known as eco-spiritualists, believe that mere secular movements alone cannot resolve the crisis completely. Although mitigation is possible, spiritual approach and attitude alone is the final way to resolution. People like me is the third group, eco-spiritualists. Ad moonu group aanu ippo ecologists il ketta appo njan samayam undarune paranju tharayirunnu ippo. So I belong to the third category, eco-spiritualist, because the secular dimension, the academics dimension, whatever you take, it is not the complete answer for the mitigation of the problem, but only spiritual approach and attitude alone can resolve the problem completely. So this is the fourth aspect I am considering. I will be confined within 5 minutes. Plant science and ecology. This is the heart of the paper. Plant science and ecology. It is the vast topic I just confined. What is the role of plants in the ecology? In answering this question, we have to go to creation theology, irrespective of religion and their disparity in teachings. Almost all religions believe in special creation by Creator God, rather than mere random evolution. Even if it is a strategy of evolution, God's guidance, tunings, and divine presence is there behind every act of creation. This is the teaching in every religion, not only Christian, but in every religion. In Holy Bible, in the first chapter, first and second verses of the book of Genesis, we read, "In the beginning of God created the heavens and earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was brooding over the face of waters." The God has specific purpose behind the creation of this universe. ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ഉദ്ദേശം അല്ലാതെ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ the creation, God has special purpose behind the creation. This purpose includes life sustenance, life perpetuation, life abundance, life celebration, life rhythmicity. There is no time, otherwise I could have explained all those things. I just confine. These are the five target aims of the Creator God as far as the creation is concerned. All these aspects are to be executed only through the togetherness and positive inter and intra relations between and among the entire created orders that include living and non-living factors along with human factors, and theocratic guidance and divine presence. If you analyze as the universe and its functions and its evolutionary sequence, it is very clear that the created God has organized not only our planet but the entire universe in such a way that everything functions in an organized and planned way, that is from disorder chaos to orderly cosmos. In this system, sun is the ultimate source of energy, and that energizes the entire system. Plants are the producers that produce food and oxygen for the entire living created orders. Animals are at different trophic levels, consumers, and microbes are the degraders and transformers of organic matter into nutrients for plants to assimilate the nutrients. The entire ecosystems in the planet is auto-sustainable in every dimension. The whole system is put into peril through anthropocentric and anthropomediated human interaction on nature for his selfish goals. In this system, I am not elaborating this aspect much as it is beyond the scope of this paper. But human interaction okay njan parayan thodangiya manikurukal edukkum, therefore I am just omitting, because the human interaction and the human mediated activities caused all sorts of damages. In the natural system, plants takes the leading role in providing almost all life requirements of other living created orders, not by themselves but in collaboration of all other created orders. This impulse of life originates along with the establishment of plants only. Even in Holy Bible, the creation story narrates that plants are the first formed organisms. In short, plants are the main resource of life. Their contribution to life includes a lot apart from food and oxygen, which are the fundamental requirement of life. Therefore, without any doubt, beyond the level of doubt, it can be asserted that plant science is the mother of all sciences. Commendable contribution of plants, I am just listing 10. Food and oxygen supply, carbon level depletion, biodiversity and its abundance, habitat formation, climate maintenance, fossil fuel deposition, medicine and curative factors, ecosystem services, water and nutrient supply and its maintenance, aesthetic panorama of nature. Idellam oru velliya topic aanu. I am not elaborating. I am leaving as a food for your future thinking and learning. Conclusion: plant science, as it traditionally called botany, is also known as plant biology or phytology. which is supposed to be the mother science of all biological sciences. Then, the purpose of God, Creator God, is five: life sustenance, life perpetuation, life abundance, life celebration, and life rhythmicity. All these activities, all these aspects are to be executed only the togetherness, parasperyada, togetherness, and positive inter and interrelations between and among the entire created orders. Plants are the main resource of life. അപ്പൊ തിരുമേനി ക്ലാസ്സിൽ എന്താ പറഞ്ഞു തന്നാൽ ഈ മൂന്ന് പോയിന്റ് എങ്കിലും മറക്കരുത്. Plants are the main resource of life. Their contribution to life includes a lot apart from food and oxygen. The plant science is therefore the mother of all sciences. ഞാനൊരു മെസ്സേജ് തരികയാണ്. ഈ മെസ്സേജ് ഡോണ്ട് ഫർഗെറ്റ്, യു ഷുഡ് റിമെമ്പർ. എല്ലാവരും എന്നോട് ചേർന്നൊന്ന് പറയുകയും ചെയ്യണം. ഐ ഗീവ് എ മെസ്സേജ് ഫോർ യു. മാക്സിമൈസ് യുവർ റിലേഷൻ പ്ലീസ് ഫോൾ with God, godly people, and godly features. Minimize your relation with evil, evil people, and evil features. Optimize your relation with your brethren, nature, and all its created orders. Thank you very much. May God bless you all. എല്ലാ ഭാവുകങ്ങളും നേരുന്നു. ഞാൻ ഇനിയും അധികം പറയുന്നില്ല. ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ഹാവ് ഗോട്ട് ദ വീക്ക്നെസ് ഓഫ് ടോക്കിംഗ് കണ്ടിന്യൂസ്ലി ഫോർ അവേഴ്സ് ടുഗദർ, ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ആം എ ടീച്ചർ ബോൺ. ജന്മന തന്നെ ഞാനൊരു അധ്യാപകനാണ്. ഇപ്പോഴും ഞാൻ സ്റ്റിൽ നാവ് ആയ അധ്യാപകനാണ്. ഞാൻ നാഗ്പൂർ സെമിനാരിൽ ഇപ്പോഴും ദ ഗ്രീൻ തിയോളജി ഒരു പേപ്പർ എടുക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. പോകുന്നിടത്തെല്ലാം ക്ലാസ്സുകളൊക്കെ എടുക്കും. സോ താങ്ക് യു വെരി മച്ച്. I consider this a privilege you have bestowed upon me. Thank you. May God bless you all. Thank you. Thank you.